Now we'll take a look at a business application of an improper integral. The accumulated present value of a continuous money flow into an investment account at a rate of $P per year perpetually, that means forever, is given by this improper integral, where K is the continuous interest rate. And there is a shortcut for evaluating this improper integral, and it's P divided by K, again, where P is the money flow per year, and K is the continuous interest rate. This is very similar to the accumulated present value formula we used before. However, this formula assumes the money flow is forever, which makes it an improper integral because the upper limit of integration is positive infinity. So let's take a look at our example. We want to determine the accumulated present value of an investment for which there is a perpetual continuous money flow of $2,400 per year at an interest rate of 1% compounded continuously. And we'll use the shortcut first, and then we'll do it the long way. So the accumulated present value is going to be equal to the money flow per year, which is $2,400, divided by the continuous interest rate as a decimal, which would be 0.01. And this is equal to $240,000, or $240,000. So this puts a value on receiving $2,400 per year forever, which would earn 1% continuous interest. And this kind of reminds me of the lottery, where you're given a choice of a lump sum or a monthly payment. The only difference is that most lotteries don't give you money forever. It's only for a certain amount of time. But this does give us a lump sum value of a continuous money flow earning interest forever. Now let's see how we would evaluate this integral by hand without the shortcut. We would have the accumulated present value equal to the improper integral from 0 to infinity of 2,400 e to the negative 0.01 t dt. And then because this is an improper integral, we'd write this as the limit as b approaches infinity of the integral from 0 to b of 2,400 e to the negative 0.01 t dt. And now we'd have to perform u substitution in order to determine this antiderivative. So we'd have u equal negative 0.01 t, du equals negative 0.01 dt. So we would divide both sides by negative 0.01. So dt is equal to du divided by negative 0.01. Now let's go ahead and write this in terms of u. I'm going to go ahead and pull out the 2,400. And we'll have the limit as b approaches infinity of the integral of, this should be e to the u, but then dt is du divided by negative 0.01. So I'll put the du here, but we can pull out this and put it in the front, negative 0.01. Let's go ahead and finish this on the next slide. And notice how we left the limits of integration off here because this is in terms of u. And the antiderivative of e to the u is just going to be e to the u, or e to the negative 0.01 t. And the limits of integration were from 0 to b. Before we replace t with b and t with 0, remember this is over 1, so we could move this down to the denominator, which would change the sign of the exponent. Let's go ahead and do that. So we'd have 1 over e to the 0.01 t. Now we're going to replace t with b and t with 0. So we'll have 1 over e to the 0.01 b minus 1 over e to the, this would be e to the 0. Looking at this fraction here, as b approaches positive infinity, this exponent increases. Therefore, this entire denominator increases without bound, and the numerator stays at 1. So this fraction approaches 0, and e to the 0 is equal to 1, so we have minus 1, so this limit is equal to negative 1. So we have 2,400 divided by negative 0.1 times negative 1, which is 2,400 divided by 0.01, which, peeking back at the previous slide, was the shortcut formula, where this is the annual money flow, and this is the continuous interest rate. So this will give us the same value of $240,000 as the accumulated present value. So you can see why in most cases you're probably going to prefer to use the shortcut, but I did want to provide one example of why this formula actually works. I hope this was helpful.